This is my everyday jacket. It's from a company called Cramster. This is their Breezer model. Bought this much before buying the bike. So it's a mesh jacket, as you can see here. Very good ventilation. I use it every day for the past 2.5 years. And it has stood the test of time. So you get these zippers here. These, they say it is waterproof, but the zippers are not waterproof. So it is not entirely waterproof. It is water resistant. You get two zippers, one on each side. So it comes with a back protector, a C-rated back protector, which goes on the back this way inside. So you have this pouch wherein you insert the back protector. So this is where it goes. Then it has C-rated shoulder pads, right? That is how it goes. Then you have these C1 rated elbow pads, which sits in here. Same goes here too. So this is my Cramster Breezer. The size what I wear is medium. Couple of points when you are looking at buying a riding jacket. One, make sure you try out the jacket with and without the liners. This is a thermal liner. It also comes with a rain liner. Thermal liner, I have used it only once on a track day for just to make the jacket much more snug. Otherwise, I've never used the thermal. So you have these zippers here, right? So the inside part is a thermal part which goes in. Then the outer part is the rain liner. Rain liners like these are not very effective. So this is worn out. This is a regular wear and tear, I guess. But the jacket has been useful. In fact, it comes with all these buckles for you to tighten yourself. It comes in for your arms, for your biceps. If you see these white lines, these are reflective. This is something which is very critical when you're getting into riding in the night or probably early mornings. Couple of things you need to remember. See as to how is that you gonna use this. If you are always gonna use it with the thermal liner, wear it with the thermal liner and see how it fits. Most of us don't use the thermal liner nor the rain liners. Make sure it is snug. When I say snug, a tight fit, but it shouldn't restrict your movements. The zipper what you see here, right? So this is something which most of the riding jackets have, which will help you tie this along with the riding pant if you happen to buy a separate riding pant. We did talk about briefly about the rain liners, right? So trust me, these are not effective. So what I would suggest is, or what I have done is, buy these regular windcheaters, one size large or two sizes large to my riding jacket. And whenever it rains, I just stop by, remove this jacket and wear it on top of my riding jacket. This is what I use for my city riding. I have not tested this on highways. Not sure how well this will resist on heavy downpour. But this should be enough for you when you're doing your city rides. That's on the jacket. This is my two-piece leather jacket what I have. This is from a company called Dainese. This is their mid variant of two-piece leather jackets. This is called the Laguna Seca Evo. This is the jacket what I use when I am doing track days. This is the jacket what I use when I am doing short rides or touring. This is something which I always wanted to buy. Took me about 2 years to save up and invest on this. This is a fully perforated one with all the protections. You have the elbow from here till here. You have this reflective. You have the shoulder protection. These don't come with a back protector or a chest protector. You need to buy separately. This is reflective. It gives a very nice glow in the night when you are doing. Right, this is reflective, this is a reflective. This is not a pocket per se, this is for ventilation. You do get a pocket in this, which is in the front. Yeah, so near the chest is where you get a pocket. It's a, it's a pocket good enough for you to put in your mobile phone. This is size 50 what I wear. What I also have is the bottom part of it. Both of them come with a zipper, a 360 degree zipper. It's a very solid zipper, a very thick YKK zipper, and goes around, comes till here. It's the most comfortable gear I've ever worn. Bought this through a D-store. You get shin protection, you get the knee protection, the hips also get some good amount of protection. Why invest on a leather for a tropical country like India? First and foremost, it's the ultimate protection one can invest on. Second, why Dainese? Predominantly reason being, there is a D-store in Bangalore, tried out multiple sizes, saw which fits me. That's the only reason why I bought the Dainese. It's nothing to do with the brand as such. If somebody is able to give me a similar kind of protection at a better price, I will definitely invest on. I have not seen anybody else come with such kind of quality of leather, such kind of stitching, and such level of protection at this price point.
He's the man.
When you're going investing on, you know, on the leather jackets, make sure that the fit is a bit tighter, because the moment you invest on these will stretch, right? So leather has a tendency of stretching. That is one. Try the gear out. Point number two, always buy perforation. For a country like India, you would require perforation. Two pieces is much more versatile than one piece. Why? Because the jacket, you can remove it. So if you have stopped by somewhere, if you're feeling hot, or if you want to freshen up, you can remove the jacket separately. The most important point is the zipper. Right, so single piece doesn't come with a zipper here. So if you want to pee, or if you want to answer the nature's call, two pieces is the way to go. Leathers are heavy, so you would be carrying about 8 kgs of weight when you're completely suited up. Even if you have a fall, this will help you save your skin. What you also need to do when you're buying leathers which are snug fit or which are tight fit is invest in a proper liner. Okay, so these are from a company called Klim. These are medium sets. This is the top part which you wear inside your leathers or inside your riding jackets. This is the bottom part, the pant what you have. The best part is this also comes with a this open thing, quite helpful. So okay, but that's a serious problem, guys. When you're in leathers, full leathers, you not being able to answer the nature is something which is a problematic thing. I also wear these when I'm doing short rides or touring, when I'm not even wearing the leathers. Helps in regulating your body temperature. So if it is colder outside, you feel warmer. If it is warmer outside, you feel a bit colder. A must is what I say. If you're riding, or if you're doing longer distance, let's say 2 hours, more than 2 hours of riding. So short rides and tourings, I would definitely recommend this, the base layers. Why? Because if you keep sweating, or sweat makes you uncomfortable, this will keep you dry. So this is something which is much more affordable. So these are from a brand called Kipsta. Available in Decathlon, very snug fit. So if you see here, there's a lot of design texture to it, which helps in perforation. What I also have is the bottom part. This is from the same Decathlon store. Doesn't have that gap here for answering nature's call, but these are quite affordable. This is from a brand called Kalenji. Hope I have pronounced it right. So this is 1000. This is 1000. When you wear it with the leathers, it becomes easier for you to remove the leathers, because leathers are pretty tight when you're wearing it, pretty snug when you're wearing it. That is how it's supposed to be. But once you start wearing this, these are very comfortable. Before the leathers, these were my knee guards. So these are from a brand called Knox. These are called Cross Max. Apparently these are not for riding, these are for biking. Sorry, when I say biking, bicycles. It says CE approved knee and shin protection. It has this alignment wherein it says, so this is for left and this is for right. So the thing with this is this is not very comfortable, and if you invest a little bit more, let's say about 1,000 rupees more, then you will might as well buy a riding pant which will give you protection on your hip and are much more comfortable than these. I don't recommend these, neither do any knee guards, because they don't provide you the protection what is required. This is my back protector. This is called the Dainese Manus. This provides you a better protection. This is your regular back protector. So this is much more bigger. I would definitely recommend going for an independent back protector. It goes with your movement. So if you are doing a lean, right, it goes along with your movement. What I like about it is this is very comfortable. These strap-ons and this makes it a very comfort fit, and it's very thin. You can see the size of it. Not something which will hinder when you're going for a ride. Very comfortable, well ventilated. I wear this every time I go for long drives. I don't use it in the city. With the leather and with my Cramster breezer jacket also. This is the rain pant what I have. So this I wear it on top of my leathers or on top of my jeans with the knee protectors. It's called Nova Dry. Comes with this zippers in the bottom, helps you tighten it with your riding shoes. During monsoon, this is what I wear on top of my my riding gear. Not tried it for long rides, used it for the recently concluded monsoons last year.